Hello my dear students, welcome to our channel Rajesh Biology. And this is Rajesh, Master Zoology. Today I am going to teach about nature, scope and meaning of zoology. First of all, our aim is, the aim of zoology is to explain the animal world in terms of scientific principles. Animal world is different from our visibility. మనం ఎలా అయితే చూస్తామో దానికి కొంచెం డిఫరెంట్గా ఉంటుంది. సో ద ఎయిమ్ ఆఫ్ జువాలజీ ఈజ్ టు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ ద యానిమల్ వరల్డ్ ఇన్ టర్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ సైంటిఫిక్ ప్రిన్సిపల్స్ అండ్ జువాలజీ స్టడీడ్ యాజ్ ఎ ప్యూర్ సైన్స్. దేర్ ఆర్ డిఫరెంట్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ సైన్సెస్. ఓకే, ప్యూర్ సైన్స్ మీన్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ ప్యూర్ బ్రీడ్. మిక్స్డ్ సైన్స్ మీన్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ డిఫరెంట్. ఐ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ లేటర్ ఇన్ దిస్ వీడియో. ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ ప్యూర్ సైన్స్ అండ్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ అప్లికేషన్ ఇన్ అదర్ బ్రాంచెస్ సచ్ యాజ్ ఇఫనిక్ అండ్ యుజెనిక్స్, biotechnology, bioengineering, bioenergetics, biopharmaceutics. Okay, these are the mixed sciences. So this pure science is help in the remaining branches. And as applied science, it is also applied science, zoology. Applied science means it applied to the remaining science. For example, biology applied to the physics, it is biophysics. If biology applied to the chemistry, biochemistry. Most of the missionaries like ECG or EEG all are working by the principles of physics only, and some missions work on thermodynamics which help in medical field, right? As applied science, it has tremendous scope. So this is zoology, and zoology have tremendous scope in agriculture, aquaculture, animal husbandry. That means veterinary, human health, diseases and veterinary science, apiculture, sericulture, pharmacology, animal breeding. There are so many branches, so many opportunities if you read zoology as a subject. And there are so many branches in zoology. Let's see one by one. First, taxonomy. The word taxonomy indicates taxis means arrangement. Taxis means arrangement. Nomos means rule. So it indicates the rule how to arrange the species within a class. Like it is the theory and practice of identification and nomenclature and classification of organisms. First we identify the group of organisms. In that group of animals, first we identify as these are the animals, they have four legs, and these animals have only two legs and two wings, so these are birds. And there are some teeny animals like insects, so butterflies are identified as a separate group. So first it is identification, then we put a name to the group or to the animal. It is a butterfly, it is a bird, it is a rabbit, it is a dog, it is a cow, it is a man. So nomenclature. After then we classify them into a separate groups for our convenience, like the animals which have two wings and capable of flying are known as aves, air life of mode. And some animals which have capable to give milk to their babies are under class mammalia. This type of classification will occur. So taxonomy is the theory and practice of identification, nomenclature and classification. Next, evolution. Very interesting topic. And the word evolution is coined by scientist Herbert Spencer. Herbert Spencer is the scientist who coined the term evolution. In the term, E means out, volva means roll. So evolution means a gradual change will come out and it rolls to the next generations. So study of origin of life and continuous genetic adaptations of organisms to the environment. During life we get so many adaptations, and that adaptations give to the remaining generations if they are beneficial. If we get some beneficial characters, we automatically transfer that characters to our next generation. So study of origin of life and continuous genetic adaptations of organisms to the environment. and gradual changes that occur in the living organisms through geological time. There are Paleozoic era, Cenozoic era. Okay, so when geological time scale is moved forward, some changes also will occur, and the changes, if beneficial, or the adaptations are beneficial, that beneficial adaptations may give to the next generation, and evolution deals with that type of changes. And then next, morphology. The word morphology indicates morphos means form, and logos means study. Remember, this logos is study, morphology, physiology, cytology, histology, whatever it is, logos means study, and morphos means form. So it indicates it deals with the external features and internal features. Okay, study of form, size, shape, color, and structure of various organisms and their tissues, organs, organ systems also. So liver is this shape, and the heart have a specialized shape. So the liver lobule is hepatic nature. So hepatic lobule is hexagonal in shape. So it deals with the study of form, size, and shape, color, of structure of various organisms and the organs, tissues also. So morphology have two branches. They are external morphology, which we can see with our naked eye, and internal morphology. And internal morphology divided into two branches. Before that, there is a definition for external morphology. It is the study of external characters of an organism. So automatically you guess the definition of internal morphology. It is the branch which deals with the internal structure. If it deals with the external characters, it is external morphology. If a branch deals with the internal structure, it is internal morphology. Now, internal morphology have two branches. They are anatomy and histology. Anatomy and histology are the branches under internal morphology. Let's see. Anatomy. Ana means up. To means cutting. So, it is the study of internal arrangement of different organs or organ systems as observed within the naked eye. So we can see with our naked eye, if we cut an animal, for example, if we dissect a rabbit or a cockroach, we can see the digestive tract of that animal, and the digestive tract is present within the body at central axis in all cockroaches. So it is its fixed position. So we can see so many organs within the body with our naked eye after dissecting. This type of structure is known as anatomy, upcutting. And then next, histology. The word histos means tissue. You have to remember this word histos, tissue, because it is very, very important to my question. What is histology? Histology is the subject which deals with the tissues. Simple. It is the study of microscopic structure of different tissues. So it is microanatomy. It is also known as microanatomy. Right. Histology is very important to my question. You have to remember this, and you can write also. Next, cytology and physiology. Cytology, cytos means cells, form, structure of cells and cell organelles. It deals with the cell form or cell structure and cell organelles. There are prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells, which I already told you. Okay, so it deals with the some features of cell, and it is a structural unit of organism. And then next, physiology. Physis means nature of function. Physics, nature of functioning. Physiology, it is the study of different body functions like digestion, respiration, circulation, excretion, all our physiological functions which occur in living things. And then next, paleontology. Very interesting it is. Paleontology. Paleo means ancient. Ancient means our early man's things. So ancient. Mana purvikulu antam. And on. On means being. Logos means science. So paleontology is the study of fossilized remains of organisms of the past geological ages is called paleontology. Here, paleontology have two branches. They are paleobotany and paleozoology. If we deal with the some fossils of plants, it is paleobotany. If we deal with the some fossils of animals, it is paleozoology. And then next, ecology. Oikos means house, and the word is known as the word is coined by the scientist Haeckel. Oikos means house, so ecology deals with our house. Here house means our earth. So it is the study of living organisms in relation to the other living organisms, like biotic factors. For example, we may interact with our pets like dogs or cats or rats, okay, and we also interact with directly or indirectly with some cows. We take milk from the cows, and birds also help us, and some insects also help us by pollination. So the interaction between the relations between organisms and abiotic factors also, like environmental factors. Abiotic means rainy season or rains or in desert there are so much hot temperature, right? And then next, genetics, my favorite topic. Genetics, very very interesting. In this word, the word genetics indicates to grow into, and this word is coined by the scientist Bateson. So what is genetics? Genetics means it is the study of inheritance of characters from one generation to the next generation. For example, there is a family. That family have four members. X and Y are wife and husbands, and A and B are their children. X have a short hair, or X is very short, so that shortness may repeat in their children A. This type of inheritance is known as deals by the genetics. So study of inheritance of characters from one generation to the next, it deals with the heredity and variations also. That means mutations. And ethology. Ethos means character. You can use this word with your friends. You have a chief ethos. Ethos means character. It is just for fun and for good remembering. Okay, ethos means character. So in zoology, we also observe the characters of animals by studying the animal behavior based on the systematic observation and recording, analysis of functions of animals with special attention to physiological, ecological, and evolutionary aspects. Like, for example, there is a zoo. In the zoo, we maintain some giraffes and elephants and some crocodiles also. And we observe the elephants and crocodiles and giraffes with some special attention, how they behave if it is a rainy season, or how they behave if it is the weather is hot, and that behavior is observed and recorded also. It may help in evolutionary aspects. In evolutionary aspects means if there is a lot of fluctuations within the environment, which type of adaptations they may get, and which type of adaptations may continue to the next generation. It is in evolutionary aspect. And ecological aspect. Ecological means when the weather is changed, how they behave with the environment, how they struggle with the environmental changes. It is ecological aspect. And physiological aspect. which type of variations, changes will occur within the body, ear, or they increase their body temperature, or rate of respiration may decrease. So this physiological aspects, it is ethology. In this science, we study the and we observe the animal's behavior with special attention. It is also very important to my question, what is ethology? Right. Thank you.